like a nightmare, kind of, you know, because I got woken up out of my sleep.
August 3rd, 2008, approximately 3 in the morning, the 1st Division responded to the area of 2nd Main upon a shooting.
A car on a bridge with a fatally wounded victim inside and no one else around.
Upon their arrival, they located Chan Isom, who had been fatally shot.
It was his birthday. Yes, it was.
Celebrating his 31st birthday, police say Chan Isom left a popular nightclub on the Indiana Riverside and began driving home.
And was sitting at the intersection just across the bridge at 2nd and Main.
Was on his way back over here to Louisville, and right when he came through the light, that's when they said it happened.
Apparently at that time, shots had rang out, and that's when Mr. Isom was struck.
An officer in the area heard shots fired and came across the scene. Here where the vehicle had multiple shots that were fired into it. The driver was struck.
After being shot multiple times, Isom's car continued south, crashing into a tree.
Just really shocking. It really is.
Family says the crime made no sense then, and it doesn't now, 3 years later. Because police haven't found a link to any suspects, family has always believed the shooting was a case of mistaken identity. It's still hard for the Isom family to accept Chan's violent death, and even harder to accept that his killer or killers haven't paid for the crime. Described as a vibrant spirit even as a young child, Chan was known as the son who could make friends anywhere.
He was very outgoing, very loving. I mean, he loved everybody. Everyone he came in contact with, he made friends with.
But that's a personality some members of the Isom family will never know, like his niece, Rikari, born just before his murder.
She has to hear about him through hearing, you know, us talking with pictures or, you know, something like that. But it's not the same as him being here spending time with us, you know.
The family has never given up hope that someone will come forward with information.
That's all we want. Why?
Right. Even if it was a mistake, just please let us have closure to know why he left this earth this soon.
That was the plea by his wife and mother then. It's the same now.
You wouldn't want someone to do that to your loved one. If you could just come forth and say something. I mean, you don't. Your identity doesn't have to be, you know, shown to everyone.
And if you have any information, you can remain anonymous. You can also bring closure to a cold case and bring closure to a family who's been waiting for justice for 3 years. If you have any information, please call the anonymous tip line at 574-LMPD. Ann Bowden, WLKY News.